day.
Oh, a happy day.
Oh, a happy day.
When Jesus wore.
Praise the Lord. Welcome to Testimony Time with Pastor Jay and with our own Bishop Hiram Jones from New Hope Apostolic Church. And we just want to give a shout out to him. Amen. God bless you, Bishop Jones. And we're here to testify to the glory of God because God has truly been so good to us. And he's brought us from a mighty long way. So we just want to let you know that Jesus Christ, he is the way, the truth, and the life. So we just thank God for you. And I pray that as you watch the show, that you will receive what God has for you, that it will definitely be a blessing to you today. Amen. God bless you. And before we go into the show, we're going to have a song by our special guest today. It's Pastor Angel Bryant. Hi, Angel.
Hi, how you doing?
God bless you.
God bless you.
So glad to have you with me today.
Thank you.
Amen.
So glad to be here.
Yes, yes, and I'm so glad to have you. And we're going to have a song by her. She is a songstress as well as a pastor. And she's going to sing, we're going to play her first release with her CD, and she will let you know how you can purchase this CD. It will be available, and she will let you know how you will be able to purchase one. God bless you as we go into this song.
When I look back on my life, things that I've done wrong and things that I've done right, sometimes I might have a long forgiveness heals and sin starts to fade. So many things seem different, but one thing remains the same. You are my Savior. You are my Lord. You are my worship, and I adore. You are my Savior. You are my Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
The only one I love forevermore. When I was lost, you came and found me.
Yes, amen.
And when I needed love, you wrapped your loving arms around me. When I was about to fall, you came.
And through your blood, my life, my truth, my every way, my past, my future, you're my today, my son.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God. We thank God for that song. The song said, "You are my everything." Yeah. And that's who God wants to be in our life. He wants to be our everything.
Everything.
And we have to make him our everything.
Yeah.
The Bible tells us that we live, we move, and we have our being. Everything
Amen.
Comes from the Lord. We were created for his purpose.
Amen.
And for his purpose alone. So, Pastor Angel,
yeah.
That was an awesome song.
Thank you.
Amen. I enjoyed that.
Thank you very much.
I have to get the CD myself.
Yes, yes. I do have copies, physical copies.
Okay.
You can also purchase it on any digital platform.
Okay.
It's entitled Angel Star, You Are.
Amen.
Amen.
That's a beautiful song.
Amen. Thank Amen. You. Written and produced by my husband.
Praise him. Amen. And we just thank God. We give God the glory. You are awesome. You're just a blessing. I've been with you for a while, and I really love you and enjoyed your testimonies mm-hmm. and how God has blessed your life.
Oh, yes.
And where you are today.
Yes.
And now you're a pastor.
Yes.
And you and your husband.
Yes.
Now has started your own work.
Yes.
Praise God
Amen.
For that.
Amen. Amen.
And I'm so glad to have you here today to testify
Glory.
To let the people know how good God has been to you and the things that you have gone through.
Yes.
To get where you are today.
Yes.
And I'm kind of going to let you start, but I know some of the things that you've shared with me about your testimony that I remember you was telling me about going through a state of depression.
Yes.
And that's one of the things that a lot of the saints or people in general goes through.
Amen.
Is depression. And we have people that even sit in church.
Yes.
And depressed.
Yes.
Because of things that are happening in their lives. And everything is such a secret.
Yeah.
You know, don't tell this, don't tell that.
Keep it between the walls.
Right. And but it's something that's festering in that person. And, you know, they saying get delivered,
yeah.
get set free. And God can. We
yes,
know
he can.
That God can do anything. But sometimes we have to get to the root of the problem.
Amen.
We have to, sometimes we have to talk to get it out. So God can heal.
Amen.
And that God can deliver.
Amen.
Because he is a deliverer. And you're here to testify
Amen.
Of the greatness of God. And you know we give God all the glory.
Yes.
Because there's nothing we can do without him.
Amen.
So would you share a little bit? I don't know where you want to start.
Sure.
You know, with depression, I think this is a really great testimony to share with the world.
Yes.
And that it will be a blessing to the people.
I sure can. I will start that, I think about the age of 4, I went through a stage of molestation
mm-hmm.
by someone that I loved and should have cared for me and took care of me.
Mm-hmm.
And it went on for some years. And after that, I went through some processes of being raped. I had bad relationships. I've been physically abused
right.
by men. I've had numerous abortions.
Mm-hmm.
I've been through so much
right.
in my life.
Yes,
and
yes.
I've attempted suicide 8 times.
Oh, my God.
Amen.
So we know that God had you here for a purpose.
For a purpose, yes.
8 times.
8 times. And the most recent.
And we thank God. Amen. That
Amen.
He kept you here. He didn't allow the enemy to take you out.
He didn't. And I thank God for mercy and
yes.
grace.
Amen.
He bestowed in me a heart that I didn't quite understand.
Mm-hmm.
And to this day, I'm still trying to understand it.
That's
but I thank
right.
God for
yes,
it.
Yes.
But dealing in depression. Depression, it's a very strong spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one that no one can really understand.
Okay.
But it's a lot of hurt.
Mm-hmm.
It deals with pain.
Yes.
It deals with darkness.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I was dealing in.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, we were raised to not talk about
right.
things.
That's
you
right.
you keep it and you just pray about it and
right.
you ask God to heal and deliver you.
Right.
And
right.
I'm
right.
a firm believer in God.
And you grew up in church.
And I grew up in church.
Yes, you did.
I was a PK kid.
But right, right. And even at that of growing up as a PK or growing up in church,
Amen.
You always had this depression,
yes,
even in the church
as a little girl,
and knowing that you can sing the way you do, you were singing,
yes,
in church,
yes,
coming up,
started at 4,
and singing in church, and you had all of this hurt, all of this that had happened to you that you really just couldn't share the way that you wanted yes. to. And you kind of just tucked it away, I would
say. I tucked it away because even I even had my first child at a really early age. Right. I got pregnant at 14. Mm-hmm. I was raped from that. Mm-hmm. And so things in my life and, you know, situations just compound on top of each other.
That's right.
And I never deal with none of it. I just kept living.
Right.
Just trying to.
So what happened to the fact that growing up in church, and I, to me, this is a blessing whether you're in the church or out of the church. Well, the thing that I want the world to know and the people to know that God is able.
Yes, he is.
He's able. And growing up in church, and you kind of tucked that away, and you smiled, and you just went along. But at the same time, you were going through.
Yes.
You was going through trying to kill yourself. You was going through, you know, the darkness of everything that you just said. So how long before you just, you know, did you go through church like this?
I've been going through church. I'll say it like this. I had my last depressional episode.
Mm-hmm.
This last March 2020,
mm-hmm.
during the pandemic.
Right, right.
And I had went through such a dark moment. I mm-hmm. didn't even know where it came from.
Right.
It just hit. Because yes. I thought I had been healed and delivered and, definitely. You know, and I had went in such a dark place. I didn't understand how I got there, and I didn't know how to come out.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And, you know, I wasn't telling my husband.
Right.
And so one day, I was sitting on the couch,
mm-hmm.
and I took a sharp object, and I slit my throat just that quick.
Oh, my God.
Just this past year.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't cut it deep enough mm-hmm. to, you know,
mm-hmm.
do a lot of damage, but as I was going for the second round of it,
mm-hmm.
my husband came in the room, and I stopped.
So it's kind of like that you had went into a place, a really dark
yeah,
place.
Yeah, it was
that
so dark.
The enemy had just come in and attacked you.
He attacked me quick.
And he kind of took you into a dark place to where...
But let me show you how God moved.
Mm-hmm.
When I did that, my husband came into the room.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, I don't know why I'm in here. He's like, but I need you to call your parents.
Mm.
And I said, and I'm just looking at him. I know what's wrong and I know I need help.
Right.
But I wasn't going to tell him.
Okay.
And so he picked the phone up and he called my parents.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, I don't know what's wrong, but I know we need to pray for her.
Okay.
And I just began to cry. And they began to pray.
Praise God.
And at that moment,
yes.
I knew God had me in his hands.
Amen.
I said, I know it's you now.
Yes.
I know it's you and it's time.
Yes.
And God took me out of that dark place, and when he brought me out of that dark place, he set someone in my life that moment
yes.
that I began to talk to
yes.
and go all the way back
okay,
and reveal all of that hurt,
all of that
pain.
Yes, yes.
You know, and I said, God.
You just let it out.
I let it out because I was always raised that you don't go to no therapist and no psychiatrist.
But
no people
came to a place
yes.
that God allowed you to yes. release everything at that time, and that was just March
and I
of
knew
2020,
that
right?
was just this past.
But my thing is, I'm trying to see how were you able to, and I know God brought you through,
mm-hmm.
but you was in church,
yeah,
PK kid, singing,
mm-hmm.
Sunday school,
yes,
church service.
I was told.
What age? Where did you get to the age where you say something wrong? I got to start dealing with. What happened? That
I knew something was wrong with me at the age of 14.
Okay.
And I knew I needed help.
So were you praying or were you in the world? What did you do?
Well, at the age of 14, I was still at home with my parents. So, and, you know, at that time, we still had, her name was Selma Abbey. She mm-hmm. was the prophetess of the family.
Okay.
She was still alive.
Yes.
And she would call revivals, and she would call all the kids forth, and,
mm-hmm.
and she would, like, tell you what was going on with you.
Right.
And so,
real prophet.
Yes, she was real. You know, because, you know, when I was praying one time, and I didn't tell anybody.
Okay.
And she called a revival, and she couldn't see. She had no sight.
And she was blind.
Yes, she was blind. And so she took my hand.
Mm-hmm.
She's talking about, who baby is this?
Oh, God.
And they was like, well, did you know your baby's pregnant? I'm like, oh, my God. She told it all.
Well, see, that was the old saints.
Yeah, those revivals, it's like she was a help to me. Because she helped me to relieve some of those things.
Okay.
And when she passed on, you know, but before she passed, she had called the revival.
Mm-hmm.
And she prophesied to every child in that family.
Okay.
And she got to me and she told me.
Okay.
You're going to take my place.
Praise God. Amen.
And I started running after that revival.
Yes.
I didn't want to take her place.
Right.
But
right.
as long as I was in the world, I was in some of the deepest, darkest depressions I had ever experienced.
Right. And that's what I was, because it's so many people in that place.
Yes.
And that's what I was trying to touch on
yes.
a little bit, how after she passed, it seemed like,
yes.
Because she had a presence.
Because I had not told you.
Kept you going.
Yeah.
Kept you functioning.
Yes.
Even though you were still hiding behind
yes.
this, what you had gone through, this darkness.
And I had went into a stage of a depression, and my phone rung one day. And it was an evangelist.
Mm-hmm.
And she called to tell me, she said, God told me to call you.
Oh, wow.
And I said, okay. She said, he told me to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
You have to sing your way out.
Amen.
See, God was always, there.
That's what I'm us.
So he said, you have to sing your way out. There's deliverance in your song.
Amen.
She said, just like you be singing for other people.
Yes.
She said, you need to sing for yourself.
Okay.
And I started doing that. So when I would go through something, God would drop a song and it'd be just what I need. And I'll be just begin to sing that thing until I sing my way up out of there.
Okay. So you was fighting.
I was
for
fighting.
Your life.
I was fighting.
But God always sent somebody
yes.
that would speak a word.
Yes.
But to those that's by themselves and they don't have that, what would you say? Because, you know, I've talked to people and I know that there's people that's in that.
Yes.
In those dark
and
places.
And what I tell them.
But they don't have the people to call them. You know, they feel alone.
Yes.
I told them about a couple of late girls that I know that was young that committed suicide because of depression. So what would you say today that someone that don't have that person? To call out, or to call them, to encourage them.
I say to those people today, find someone.
Find someone.
Someone.
Don't just continue to sit there.
Things that are in the dark
fester,
and they gain control.
Okay.
You have to put those things out in the open. Okay. Because even when you can't pray for yourself, there's somebody that can pray for
Amen.
You. And that was one of the things I needed.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew that I had people praying for me just because I was raised in the church.
Right.
You know, but there's someone out there that has not been in the church.
Right.
Ain't nobody praying for them like that.
That's what I'm saying. So you got the ones that's not
so
in church.
I need those.
Yes.
To go to someone. They need to speak. You need to talk. You need to reveal those things. Don't be ashamed.
Even if they have to call you.
You can call me. 313-629-5483. It doesn't matter. You can call me day in, day out. My line is always open.
Yes.
My children call. I got strangers calling.
Yes.
Because this is a serious thing.
Yes, yes.
This kills.
Amen. And I don't think we, because we've never been through it, and a lot of people don't understand. But being with you, you have allowed me to kind of look into how bad depression
yes.
can be on people. Just listening to your testimony and some of the things that we have talked about. And I was like, Lord, it's a place that I've never been, but it's really a dark place to be in. And you don't know how to get out of it. And like you say, it seems like when you stay in that dark place, the enemy just keep compounding.
Yes.
Just keep, you know, one lady say, just keep talking. You're not worth anything.
Yes.
Nobody love you. Nobody cares about you. You just should kill yourself.
It glorifies your lack of worth.
Because
we already think we're not worth anything.
Okay.
We think we're the reason all the things happen. We think we're the cause. Even though we don't speak it out loud, we think that.
Okay.
You know, I think maybe, what did I do
at
to make him do
old.
Or make them do what they did to me?
Exactly.
Or, you know, what did I say? How could I have done it differently?
And,
you know,
right.
and you're carrying it on yourself.
Wow.
So, the first to be delivered, you got to forgive yourself.
Okay. Acknowledge.
Acknowledge it.
What it happened.
That it happened.
It was wrong.
It was wrong, and you need to forgive yourself.
Yes.
It wasn't your fault.
Yes.
It's all right. Mm-hmm. It was not your fault. Right. And once we learn how to do that,
amen,
then we can work on forgiving that person. Okay. Not for the person's
and
sake,
I was gonna get
but
to
for
that.
Your sake. You have to learn how to forgive that person. Mm-hmm. We're not saying that they need to get away with it,
that's
but
right,
you need to forgive them so that you can live.
Yes.
You got to be able to live.
Yes, yes.
And as long as you're hating, mm-hmm, you're steady dying.
Okay.
And them people done lived on and doing what they want to do.
Ain't thinking nothing about you.
Ain't thinking nothing about you.
And here you left in a dark place.
And so, if we learn how to forgive,
because mm-hmm,
like the Bible says, you mm-hmm have to forgive.
Mm-hmm.
As God forgave you, you have to forgive your brothers and sisters
that's
that
right
wrongly mistreat you.
That's right.
We have to do that.
Yes.
It's so important to
yes
have a heart of forgiveness.
Amen. So were you ever in a state that you didn't want to forgive?
Yes, in my younger years.
You did?
But
uh-huh,
I really think, you know what? And that's why I say I thank God for my heart.
But yes, such a...
I have such a forgiving heart.
And you also had you had a lot of church in you.
Yes.
And the word of
so
God.
So I don't know if I hated as I some people think I should have
right,
because
yeah
of everything I've done. But I've had some animosity towards mm-hmm those people
you
at times.
You did go through that.
But I never stopped dealing with the people.
Okay.
You know, I just
God
I just you learned how to live with them.
Okay. Okay.
I did, you know, I've confronted my issues
mm-hmm
and those that wronged me. I've asked them.
And I think that's good what you just said.
Yes.
I've confronted
yes
my issues. And to get to the root of a problem,
yes,
you have to confront it. And
you
sometimes
have to.
Those issues are so ugly.
Yes.
That you don't want to. When you confront issues, you feel it again.
Yep, and that's
you
what people
it.
People are so afraid of the unknown.
Yeah.
Something they can't control.
Right.
But in order to live and to be delivered, you have to go to a vulnerable moment that a lot of people don't want to
and
read.
Just pull out.
Exactly.
And give it to God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And God has brought you here today.
Mm-hmm.
And then even after all that time that you growing up,
mm-hmm,
and now you have your children, but even now, you still have little bouts about depression.
Yes.
But it's over now.
Mm.
But that was the last one.
That's the last one. No more. And even with that, because, you know, my children,
mm-hmm,
they go through,
mm-hmm,
you know. So, and, it you know, God, it's like he takes me through so many things
yes
so that I can help.
That's others. Right, other people.
So, like, if my children are going through, they
yes
can call me.
Yes.
You know, and I'm glad that I have something
yes
that I can give them.
Yes. Yes.
You know, by being a witness, a living witness,
right,
that God
right
is able.
Yes.
And that's what people need today. They
yes
need living witnesses, but we can't be a living witness because we don't want to tell nobody we're going through nothing.
Well, that's true.
We're so saved till we ain't no good
well
in the
go
church.
Go ahead and preach.
We're just so, I don't want to be so saved that I can't help somebody
well
get
well
saved.
Well, you know earthly good.
Exactly.
Amen.
I don't want to be that.
That's
I want
right
to be, God said we're supposed to be a tangible witness.
Yes, yes.
Mean that we're supposed to be that living, touching thing
yes
that God is.
Yes, yes.
So I have to let you know that God is something to me. He's
yes
a deliverer. What did he deliver you from? I mean, you know.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't.
No,
you have to tell me what you've been delivered from
well,
that, so I know that you've been delivered.
We overcame by the word of our testimony.
Come on. But don't nobody testify no more.
We don't know.
We don't want to testify.
Testimony,
no, we just talking.
Like
we testifying about a check God sent in the mail in the brand new car. We ain't testifying about God delivered us from them beat downs we was getting, and he delivered us from the rapes and the molestation. We don't want to testify about
and
that.
I remember the old saints used to testify about the,
yeah,
some of the things. I recall one of the old saints was saying that they was in the bars.
Yeah.
You know. They was serving, looking. I'm looking at these mothers like, what? Oh, my God.
And but the greatest
you know
point.
But
the,
now we're away from that.
And you know what, Pastor? The greatest part of the testimony,
mm-hmm,
when people hear and listen to you,
yes,
is that they don't see the life
mm-hmm
on you.
Right.
They be like, I can't. No.
Girl,
you did all that?
Exactly.
I don't see that.
I know.
I say, I know. I don't look like what I've been through.
That's what I said.
That's the testimony.
They got to say, I don't look like what I've been through now.
I don't look like those bruised and broke ribs and black eyes. I don't look
glory
like that.
To God.
You know what I'm saying? I did my drugs.
Yeah.
I did my alcohol. I don't look like
so
all of that.
So you went through that.
Yeah. I
and
did
so
prostitution. Oh, my goodness.
Hold on a minute. We're going to share some more with the world because People going through this.
They're going through.
See, you look, there's a hole. And they're looking to fill that hole.
Exactly.
So like you say, you're running from
it. I'm running from it. From and I'm trying to find love. And the love that I thought I should have got, but I didn't get.
So you went to drugs?
I went to drugs. I was a drinker. I did drugs. Mm-hmm. I slept with men. I did homosexuality. Mm-hmm. I was just running.
Right, right.
And I had got to the point. One day I left. I was a truck driver. Mm-hmm. And I applied for a job and it sent me to Oklahoma.
Okay.
Nebraska. And I was in a motel room.
Mm-hmm.
And in that motel room, I found myself alone.
Okay.
And when I say alone, mm-hmm. I didn't feel the Spirit of God nowhere.
Wow.
And I would used to always feel him convicting me and, you know, trying right. to, hey, come on, through. Right. You know, right. I didn't feel him no more.
Oh my God, you went into a dark place.
I was
place
so
and
dark.
Didn't feel nothing.
And I ended up face down on the floor, just mm-hmm. crying.
My God.
Begging God.
Then I look back on my life. Things that I've done wrong and things that I've done right. Sometimes I might have lost my way. But even in the middle of mistakes, I'll say, you are my Savior. So many nights I lie awake, repenting from all of my past mistakes.
For a happy day.
For a happy day.
For a happy day. When Jesus
walked.
Oh, when he walked.
Everybody, this is your girl Vicki Winans, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Hi, I'm Clifton Davis, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy D. Hattie watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Hi, everybody. I'm telling you, everything that happened to me that was good, God did it. I'm Evelyn Turrentine, AG, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Pastor D. Alexander Bullock, the Preachers of Detroit, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.